What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Mike Dolce Show. I come from a wrestling background, amateur collegiate wrestling. I transitioned into powerlifting, and then from there straight into, you know, I was always peripheral on combat sports, working as just as a wrestler. But then when powerlifting was over, it was into the MMA gyms for another 10 years. During that transition, kind of from wrestling, weight class oriented, right, sucking down as far as possible, but really we look at kind of the power to kg ratio, you know, kind of lean mass ratio and such, and then to powerlifting, it's really the Wilkes score once again, trying to be as strong as possible at the lightest possible body mass. MMA, kind of same thing. I figured out in my mid-20s or so, after being 282 pounds, where super strong, power so strong, I could literally run through a brick wall. I mean, I couldn't run around it because I'd pass out and have a heart attack. But I could, you know, I could.
What do you weigh now? What's the comparison? So you were 280 then. What do you weigh around now?
I was 280 then. I went all the way down to 170, where I fought a little bit on the Ultimate Fighter in the IFL. So I fought professionally for a few years while I was the head strength coach, MMA coach at Team Quest, you know, Randy's gym, back in the 2004-05. Through 2010. Ultimate Fighter I did in 2008. So that was kind of, I was 280 at like 26 years old or so. And then by the time I was 32, I was down to 170. So right now I'm about 220 or so, but I just went through a lean bulking phase. So I'm like 220 and about 11% body fat. My goal is to be 8% body fat May 1st. Mm-hmm. Which is, and you know, this is how
I like the target. There's a date there.
Yeah, Carolyn, you know how it is. If I don't have a date in front of me, it's like I can be a mess. Because
We all need a reason, a purpose, a point at which we work towards. Yeah, 100%.
Have to have another summit, you know, in front of us that keeps us on track. Because when I get out of bed, I'm that guy. I need some focus in my day, or I'm going to find something to focus on that you know, kind of might not be well thought out. Not from a bad, you know, I can get busy wasting time in the gym instead of really being progressive. But at my age, 43 years old, it's hard to put on lean tissue anymore. If I can add, you know, 3 pounds of lean muscle tissue in 3 months, 4 months, that's a lot, right?
It is. Yeah.
So it's not like when we were kids, we can add, you know, 20 pounds of muscle in a year, no problem. And I had a few years like that too. So now my goalposts certainly changed. So after this lean bulk, if I can keep 2 extra pounds of muscle tissue I didn't have last year while getting my body fat down, man, I'm over the moon. That's a huge high five, right? You know, for me, and it kind of keeps it going. And then we'll see what I want to, you know, morph into over the summer period. So I kind of do my thing in quarters. But that all, you know, being 280 or so, I had health issues. 26 years old, I had sleep apnea, hypertension, high blood pressure, morbidly ill. I was like 30% body fat. I looked like just a big square. You know, I was benching over 500 pounds, deadlifting over 7. I mean, I was that guy for a little while.
Strong, yeah.
Super strong.
Weight moves weight, right?
That exactly. I love that. You're right.
Yeah.
But for what? For a plastic trophy. You know, it was just so silly. Like my mother and my girlfriend are like the only two people in the audience at my comp, you know, which is, that's not really what it's for, but just, it shows how ridiculous it is. And then when I really started working with the high level athletes, the Olympians, you know, at that level, it really came down to being very specific, very targeted. And none of performance really comes at that macro level. So we really found it all came at the cellular level. If you don't have enough calcium or zinc or magnesium or iodine, phosphorus, I don't care what your protein intake is. I don't care what supplement you're taking. I don't care what steroid you're injecting. Mm. If you have these, you know, very specific micronutrient deficiencies, you will not be competing optimally, nor will you live as long. Your career won't be extended as well. You won't get to that next contract. You won't make that bigger payday where you get the extra zero added to your, right? We all want those extra commas added to our paychecks. That's not going to happen because you're going to tear out your shoulder or your hip or your back or something like that in your mid late 20s before you get to that arc. So kind of the, you know, wrap up the conversation. It's the micro level, the micronutrition. And you know, you really talked on restoration now where, you know, like myself also, much of my training is 45 minute intensity, 3 or 4 days a week, let's say. I also have my low intensity. You mentioned kind of my low walks, my low intensity work. I got a pre-core, like all that stuff. easier work. I mean, I'm at the sauna and the banyan, the cold plunge. I'm hitting yoga classes. I'm foam rolling. I'm doing more of that stuff than I am the hard intense stuff now.
Yeah, it's the same. I went on a retreat to Costa Rica with the XPT experience run by Laird Hamilton and Gabby Reese. It was with Team Omax, actually.
Was PJ there, PJ Nestler?
Yeah, he was. Yeah, I met PJ. Yeah, really good guy.
Good guy. I did a conference with him a while back, so awesome.
With as part of XPT or?
No, it was for the NSCA. We did a strength coaching conference.
Yeah.
A while back. I met him, had dinner with him.
So much. Yeah, from him, the breathing work, the breath work, you know, and Laird is a huge proponent, again, if it's about longevity, it's about preserving the cells and the body. And we did this, you know, we did the ice bath. And I hadn't done an ice bath since I was competing and I was back at university. So we did the ice bath, alternating with the sauna. And I'm not going to lie, it was tough. You know, I haven't put it, you know, as everyone watching, we're all doing it one at a time. You want to be strong. You want to be that person that can do it. 3 minutes in the ice bath, into the sauna, back into the ice bath, back into the sauna. We did that twice a day, every day on the retreat, combined with the breath work, combined with underwater swimming, weight training underwater, you know, and just holding the breath, et cetera. And then the fun stuff, we got out to go out and surf with Laird Hamilton and all that kind of fun stuff. But yeah, I came back from that and I was like, okay, I don't really have anywhere to do an ice bath myself. I can put a few ice cubes in the bath, but no, I'm going to achieve. So, you know, doing cryotherapy and, you know, the infrared and stuff like that. And yeah, it's expensive. A lot of it can add up. There's ways to do it yourself, you know, buy a big shovel of ice and, you know, put it in, you know, even just waking up with a cold shower. I did it this morning, so I hadn't done it for a while. Just had showered as normal, then just ice blast, cold blast for, you know, about 2 minutes, turning around in that.
Yeah.
And it does, it just wakes up the nerve endings and the cells and everything. So yeah, just opening my mind to things like that that I hadn't done in a long time was pretty powerful for me. And then just trying to include that more in my day to day. But I realized for some people, there's not access to that kind of thing, or it's not practical to necessarily do on a daily basis, but just finding something that you can do, you know, that in your environment that works for you. Say you work in an office every day, you know, you can't just head off to a cryotherapy. There's probably not one in maybe your part of the country, whatever it is, but just the small things, you know, ice areas that are inflamed, you know, natural anti-inflammatories like ginger and stuff like that I said. But yeah, it's definitely been an evolution